Coming up on KCTV, some tips on getting into a military academy.
Also, we brush up on the benefits of reading and a quick overview of FCCLA.
All that and more, because KCTV starts right now.
Centennial.
You won't get drafted, but you can apply. I'm Tony.
And I'm Liam. Welcome to KCTV. We visited Mrs. Townsley to get an inside scoop on what Centennial students need to know.
Good morning, Centennial. I have a couple of things to share with you today, things that are going to be happening in the Career Center, and I hope that you're all paying attention. The first thing I want to share with you is that I would like to do a session on the military academies. We have five military academies. We have the Naval Academy, the Air Force Academy, West Point, which is the Army. We have the Merchant Marine Academy, and we have the U.S. Coast Guard Academy. So I think as freshmen and sophomores and juniors, if this is something that you guys want to do, you need to start early and build up your resume. So I have a sign-up sheet, and if you are interested in attending a military academy session, please come and sign up on this sheet. The military academies can be an awesome way to get your education. It's paid for, it's very prestigious. If you don't know anything about it and you're a really great student, come and talk to me and we'll sign you up for the session. Second session I wanna do is for maybe juniors, sophomores, maybe some seniors, but I want to have a session where I highlight all the community colleges that are out of state who charge in-state tuition for Idaho residents. So you could go to Portland or Seattle and go to community college and not pay out-of-state fees. So I really want to make sure you're aware of what those schools are. So I have a sign-up sheet for that, and we're going to have a big information session on that. Seniors, listen up. This is a message from Ms. Moak. If you are planning on attending a BYU university, BYU is not accepting your test scores through Naviance, so you need to go see Ms. Smoke immediately, ASAP, today, tomorrow. And she can email you your test scores and you can send your test scores to BYU that way. Makes no sense to me that they're allowing that, but not Naviance, but not for me to judge. Anyway, go see Ms. Smoke if you're attending a BYU university.
Reading is something we do a lot here at school. KCTV's Tyson Cadell has more.
Reading, whether it's strictly for business or also for pleasure, everyone has to do it. But why should we?
Well, I think in order to have an educated, intelligent society, we need to be readers and we need to be critical users of information. We should be reading for information and learning in our classes, and we should be reading for pleasure, we should be reading for fun, and we should be reading whatever we want to read during those times when we just need to escape into a good story.
Still, some people aren't convinced that reading is for them.
My advice is that they haven't found the right book for them. Enjoying reading is not about enjoying what I like to read or what you like to read. It's about every reader finding their own book, finding their own genre, something that they like to read. So if a student says they don't like to read, it's just because they haven't figured out which genre best suits them. Everybody is unique and you should be reading what you like.
As a librarian, Mrs. Marker deals with books every day. She, out of anyone, would definitely have opinions on a lot of books.
I have an example here of one of our latest new books, Turtles All the Way Down by John Green, and this is actually a signed copy. We have two signed copies by John Green, so come in and place a hold on this book. There's a long lineup of students waiting to read this book, so place a hold, and then when it's your turn, we'll let you know. Oh, I have a lot of favorite books, but one of my favorites is The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho.
Tyson Cadle, Centennial High School, KCTV.
The FCCLA is a club that works to make the community a better place. Here's one of its members with more.
Hello, my name is Emery Gray. I'm the secretary for our FCCLA chapter. We are the Family Career Community Leaders of America. And it's just so much fun being a part of this family. And We come up with these great fundraisers. We have the Humane Society fundraiser soon. And we have Patriot Perks that goes straight into our accounts that allows us to travel. We just had our fall conference where we got to learn about suicide prevention and other topics that kind of help us help the community. And we're coming up with our leadership projects, which in my opinion are the best. And yeah, I really recommend that everyone gives it a try.
And finally, if you start to hear music over the loudspeaker, it's time to boogie. Sources of Strength is getting everyone up and dancing as they promote unity and fun.
I'm there for the next dance. And that's KCTV for today. I'm Liam.
And I'm Tony. Have a groovy Wednesday.
I'm tired.
They said there'll be snow at Christmas. They said there'll be peace on earth. But instead it just kept on raining. A veil of tears for the virgin birth. I remember one Christmas morning, a winter's light and a distant choir, and the peal of a bell and that Christmas tree smell, and eyes full of tinsel and fire.